Good afternoon, students. Let us continue with the chapter sound. This is video number 24, part 3. So far, we have done that there are three types of characteristics of sound. The first one, which we have discussed, that is loudness and amplitude. The second one is pitch and frequency. Pitch and frequency. The third one is timbre. So these are the three characteristics of the sound. So one, we have done loudness and amplitude. So today we will discuss the factors on which the loudness of sound depends. Factors on which the loudness of sound depends. The first factor is amplitude of the wave. This we have discussed. When a source of sound vibrates with greater amplitude, it sends a greater amount of energy. The energy received at the ear drum of the listener is large, so the sound heard is louder. Now, one demonstration is there. For this demonstration, we required a drum, a drumstick, ping pong ball. So, what we have to do in this case, place the ping pong ball on the drum, then beat the drum gently with the drumsticks. A weak sound is heard, and the ball jumps up and down slowly. Then third one is beat the drum harder with the drumsticks. The drum produces louder sounds. Ball jumps up and down higher. It means the amplitude increased on harder drumming. Then the next is distance of source of sound. Means which produces the sound. So closer the source, louder is the sound. If the listener is away from the source of sound, weak sound is heard. If the listener is close to the source of the sound, louder sound is heard. No sound is heard if the listener moves far away from the sources. Let the train is coming and it is quite far away from you. A very weak sound is heard. As the train is approaches to you, the sound will be louder and louder. And when the train reaches at you, you will find that the sound is quite louder. And when the train moves away from you, far away from you, slowly, the sound becomes faint. So we can say that the distance of source of the sound is the one of the factor on which the loudness of sound depends. Then the third factor is surface area of the source of sound. A large surface area of a source of sound can vibrate with more energy. So more the surface area of the source, more is the loudness of the sound. There are bells of many shapes and different size in temples. The wells of big size produce louder sound than that of small size. Then this is one of the important factor, sensitivity of the ears of the listeners. Means different listeners have a different sensitivity of hearing. So the loudness of sound depends on the sensitivity of the ear of listener. A louder sound for a listener may not be so loud for the other listener. To a hearing impaired person, an intense sound is weakly heard. Now the next is loudness and amplitude. This relation we have done. Loudness is directly proportional to the square of the amplitude. One example is given. Two sound waves of amplitude 10 mm and 5 mm are of same frequency. Find the ratio of their loudness. So loudness is directly proportional to the square of the amplitude. Square means 10 into 10, 5 into 5. 100 upon 25. 100 upon 25, this is 4. So L1 ratio L2 is equal to 4 ratio 1. Now, again, the important points. You must prepare it for the next exams. Unit of loudness is decibels. First of all, well is the unit of loudness. It is named after Alexander Graham Bell, who invented telephone. The loudness of sound is practically measured in decibel, and its symbol is dB, which is 1/10 of the well. In other words, you can say that 1 decibel is equal to 1/10 of well. 1 decibel is equal to 1/10 of the well. So these are the important points which you can prepare for the exams. So decibel is the practical units. This unit basically refers to relative ratio of the power of sound waves. Say for example, the ratio of 1 kilowatt. 1 kilowatt means this is the SI unit of power of a sound wave with respect to reference sound wave of 1 watt. In the log scale is 30 decibel. You need not to worry about this. This unit can be used in both plus and minus side. For example, the ratio of 1 milliwatt to 10 watt in this scale comes out to be 40 decibels. You need not to worry about it. Now, 0 decibel does not mean 0 sound. 0 decibel comes up when loudness of given sound is equal to the loudness of the reference level. Similarly, 10 decibel comes up when given loudness is 10 times that of reference level. But 20 decibel comes up when the given loudness is 100 times that of the reference level. Say some given decibel levels of the same sources: whispering 30 decibel, talking 50, traffic 10, 80, industrial hammers 110, siren 120, rocket launch 140 decibels. Now, again the important point, the safe level of sound for hearing is up to 75 decibels. The sound of level 10 decibels to 30 decibels are soothing to ear. A sound level of 140 decibels can cause permanent damage to the ears of the listener. Such sound is called noise. So you can note, underline this soothing here. What is the level of sound for soothing to ear? Now the safe level, that is the 75 note on this. Now the next is pitch. Pitch means the shrillness of sound. Pitch means the shrillness of the sound. Pitch, the second characteristic is pitch, which is also known as shrillness of a sound. Now, pitch of the sound is directly proportional to the frequency. Means, if the frequency is more, the pitch of the sound is also more. And it is that characteristics of the sound by which we can distinguish between the voice of male and female. Because the voice of the female is quite shriller voice. So that is why we are able to hear, or we are able to say that this is the voice of the female and this is the voice of the male. So it is the characteristics of the sound that differentiate shrill sound from a flat sound. It depends on the frequency of sound wave. To understand this, let us revise the time period, some terms which are related with the sound. One is time period. Time period means it is the time taken by a vibrating particle of a medium to complete one oscillation or vibration. Like, let this is a simple pendulum. Okay? And let this is the mean position. I am writing in this is the mean position. Let it is means allowed to vibrate. Let vibrate from mean to extreme. This is the extreme position. From here to here. Then it again come back. Then from here to here. This is again extreme position. Moving like this. And then it come back. It means, so the time taken by a vibrating particle of a medium to complete one oscillation means 4 vibration made one oscillation. Mean to extreme, extreme to mean to extreme, then again extreme to mean. So 4 vibration that is equal to one oscillation. So the SI unit of time period is, everybody knows, that is seconds. This is the SI unit. Now the wavelength it is represented with letter lambda. This is lambda. I am writing here lambda. Wavelength is represented with this lambda. Now this, the distance covered in one cycle of the wave is called its wavelength. It is represented by the Roman letter lambda. Unit of wavelength is meter. This is the unit, meter. In sound waves, the distance between two consecutive compression and two consecutive rarefaction is equal to one wave length. Like, sound is a longitudinal waves. So when it propagates through the medium, it propagates like this. When a sound waves propagate through the medium, it propagate in the form of compression and rarefaction. Compression means where the molecules are very dense. Rarefaction means where the molecules are very rarer or less. So this is called compression rarefaction. Now the distance between two consecutive compression and one rarefaction is known as wave length, or the distance between two consecutive rarefaction or one compression, that is also known as wave length. So this is longitudinal waves and how it propagate through the medium. It propagate through the medium in the form of compression and rarefaction. The distance between two compression and one rarefaction is known as wavelength, and it is represented with lambda. Or the distance between two rarefaction and one compression, that is also known as wave length. Then the next is frequency. It is, you can write it by f or nu or n. F, nu or n, this is the frequency. Frequency means the number of vibration, like this, the number of vibration made in 1 second. The number of vibration made in 1 second by the vibrating object, that is known as its frequency. So the SI unit of frequency is SI unit is hertz, and it is represented with HZ. And frequency is the reciprocal of the time period. Frequency is the reciprocal of the time period. So this topic is not there in your syllabus, pitch and frequency in relation to working musical instrument, wind, membrane and string. This topic is not there. So that's all for today. Thank you very much.